Cheers, brother. There's probably a lot of tire smoke out there right now from those previous guys. A little bit hard to see that first flipping by a second flipping foot. So these guys are going in a little aggressive, but driving right into the sun. Part of this first session will be coming out here in just a moment.
Really?
I see Dan Bronca heading out there. Officer Dan, if you guys haven't seen it, be sure to check out Drift 4, the latest motorcycle versus car drift video by Dan Bronca and the Icon Motorcycle Stunt Team. All right, track is hot for this next group of drivers. Here comes our next driver. Looks like that's hurt. That VARX7 twin, Garrett Turbo on that car. He just came back from final bout. The Navigar 7 just does lose grip right here before the final apex. Here comes two guys, Rob Parsons, fortunately Rob and Dan, both had a similar color. Yes, that is Rob Parsons, the chair slayer himself. Comes Forrest Lang in the pit nuts lab car. And they make an emergency pass on his teammate though. There's the 11, S13 going back around again. Along with the only RX7. One of the few rotary cars we actually have out here. Here comes George Kirk. RX7 turns out to be 1.6 with Turbo from a Mazda Miata. There's some very interesting every time you come out here. Well, looks like Brandon Whitney had a little bit of an issue there with a follow driver. But the RX7 shows you that you can pretty much put anything into a rear drive car and come out and drift with it. And if you want to start drifting yourself, be sure to check out and find your local drift pro-am and grassroots drift event so you can come out here and start drifting yourself in your rear-wheel drive car or converted rear drive car. At least you believe those happen. In Formula Drift, we have a couple of PCs like that. And it looks like we have a small issue going out from the track right now. Got the track is going to be cold here for just a moment. Can't really see what that is at the moment. Now, unfortunately, it looks like Chair Slayer may be having some issues as well. He's out there a little stuck, but hopefully he'll get back in the pits, get fixed, and have something ready either before the end of this group session or before the beginning of the next one. So again, Rob's car is hand control. He does not have use of his feet. He's paralyzed from the waist down. So everything he does from